Hey, fish fam and friends, just sitting here, actually at my breakfast table, and had a stream end a little early and waiting to go to another stream, so I thought what better time than to slow down and take a look at this first tank here on the rack. It's a mix of some really, really nice guppies. And I think their genes pretty much speak for themselves. All kinds of fish in there. Also have some of Pam's dwarf sage. It's not so dwarf anymore. It's gotten pretty big. Doing great in here in this particular tank. Also have some, there are some calls in here also from the Hawaiian blues that you heard Bentley talking about from the Roebuck. There's one of those there. Just didn't quite cut the grade. I see one up here that I'm thinking about pulling back out though. Where did we go? Let's see him now. Sometimes I pull them a little early, better safe than sorry. Some of you remember Bam Aquatics, I'm sure. It's our friend Rick. He got out of the hobby or downsized several months ago. He's down near Susan in southern Alabama. Yeah, just sitting here looking at all the pretty guppies and all the colors, and let's see, the only other things in this tank are some snails, of course, as well as some, what am I trying to say, some real super red, oh wow, look at that guy, oh yeah, there's some American greens in here too, not pure ones, but culls, that would be one there. This looks pretty good though. Oh, super red picos. There are two in here, and I think they're the same sex, even though I thought I had a pair sexed. Well, maybe they're just not quite old enough yet. And those are my infamous mistake guppies. You'll notice right away a magenta gene in those. And they also have American greens in them. That's probably fifth or sixth generation in there. They just keep on going. But you'll see there are three or four main types that the genes have settled into. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna start selling those now that it's warmed up. That tank is pretty crowded, so I can see all the front. And then I won't be able to get down there close. Well, that's pretty close. Because I don't want to get up. Those are my Santa Maria Endlers and Ben's fish. And those are awesome, awesome fish. I do cull those out, but I don't share or sell those culls because I want to keep that line at a very, very high level of distinction. I worked on it for 2 years to get them where they are, so I'm going to try and keep those standardized. You can find Santa Maria's, but not at this level of near perfection. A little braggy, but you know, he did all the work, so I need to keep the standards there. I'm planning to send him back some of the longer tails, the smaller tails. He mentioned he might like to try those. He's still working with that line to some degree. All right, we're right at 5 minutes, so I'm gonna get myself a little snack before going into this next stream.
but it wouldn't be fair not to mention these guys. These are also Luke Roebuck guppies, and they're the Roebuck Reds. And they are not quite the most valuable guppy I have, even though it would take a lot for me to sell a pair or a trio of those guys. There's also a couple of killifish, but I was trying to, there's something wonders in there, just kind of for population control, but I don't think they really predict that much on the fry. I need to pull them out anyway. But yeah, Doug Gray is how I've got these guys, and he also had worked about 10 years a minute, you know, on the bringing this line back up, and you don't see the reds very often. You do see the blues occasionally. Bentley was saying the other day in Susie Q's stream, they're rare, extremely rare. Even now, they're rare. But these reds are even rarer and redder. yeah, I love the reds. There's nothing I have that compares with those. The blues are gorgeous. The Santa Maria's Endlers are gorgeous. So these are the fish right here. Very healthy fish. He brought the line up. He kept bringing new genes into them, and a very strong strain. So that's all I'm going to show. That's these larbs, whose name I don't remember. Let us look at them. Probably not. Not barbs, they're tapers, sorry. And I just realized I'm talking really low. So you're not hearing me. Alright guys, thanks for looking at my guppies. Look at those guys. Besides plants and lots of moss and stuff for the babies. There are a bunch of babies in there within your account that they come out and feed. Lots of snails. Okay, guys. Take care. Thanks for sharing this few minutes with me.